Good Thursday evening, Carol with you till 8 on Class 95's cartoons. Welcome into the show.
Which one is better looking?
Lisa.
Very good.
Because she is a girl, and I asked her many times that how you feel when you saw a person pass away. So she told me that she is putting her heart in, and she will definitely carry on, and she's brave to take care of everything.
I think she's a very brave woman. Of course, I'm proud of her to be able to do all this that usually would be a job of a man.
I don't find death taboo to me because it's part and parcel of life. Everyone needs to go through this phase. For me, it's a matter of respect, and this is a very meaningful career for me.
I'm Jenny Tay, and I'm a funeral director.
As an undertaker, there is no off days for us to look forward to. We have no public holidays. We have to answer phone calls 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m. in the middle of the night. And when we answer phone calls from bereaved families, we need to appear alert. We need to appear like we have not just woken up.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear about that, ma'am. May I know what's your location right now? Okay. Can. I'll see you in the hospital in 45 minutes time. Take care, ma'am. Okay, bye-bye.
Most of the time, the wake will happen on the same day. What I'll do is, firstly, I'll talk to the family, comfort them, check with them where's the location of the deceased. Then I'll head down to meet them straight away so that we can plan the funeral arrangements. Following which, what I'll do is I will collect the body from the hospitals or the homes and then send back to our palace for embalming. And I'll start the lasting process with all my suppliers to ensure that the funeral arrangement is all well arranged. So what I'll do is I'll make sure everything is well coordinated before the family arrives at the wake. I've actually heard a lot of stereotypes that, you know, people tell me about, like, for example, you know, being a woman, you shouldn't be in this trade, lah. Or you're so educated, why do you need to be in this line? But I actually think that, you know, it's the wrong impression of this industry, and this is something that I would like to change. As a woman, I am more sensitive with my emotions. I'm more in touch with the feelings of the families. So it's very natural for me to take care of them and their feelings, their needs. Growing up, when my friends ask me, what does my dad do for a living? And when I say undertaker, they will be like, oh, wow. And, you know, silence.
Of course, I was scared at first when she was telling me all about the undertaking businesses and share with me about how these processes went through, how they collect the bodies, how they handle the body, clean the body, and display the body for however long before burning it. So it was only after a long time and I began to accept that it is part and parcel of life. I somehow see that, you know, maybe one day she would also be doing the same thing as her daddy is, or somehow related to it.
I studied marketing and management when I was in university because I actually liked the subject marketing very much. So moving forward after I graduate, I pursue events and advertising career for about 4 years. But at the back of my head, always, I mean, ever since I was 18 years old, I had always asked my dad, whether I could join him in his trade.
I wanted to go for further study because nowadays it's a different society like before. See? Nowadays, most youngsters, they do their things all in a high-end way. And then come back, if you want to, then at the right time, I will let her to come in to join me.
Hello, Baba. Where are you? Oh, okay, okay. I'll go pick you up in 5 minutes time. You give me a while. My dad has always been my role model. He is my guidance in life. Every time when I face problems, I always approach him and he will give me the proper advice about how to proceed further. So his health wasn't in very good condition and I went to visit him in the hospital. He was very frail and I was quite upset by it. Hey, Baba, what did the doctor say?
Doctor said I got high blood because I had not much sleep, is it?
Yeah, you every day wander so late, 3, 4 a.m. It's not a good thing, but yes, it's a turning point. It's in a way a catalyst for me to join this trade.
I told Jenny my job is actually very tough and it's 24/7. She already asked me many times to be an undertaker.
So I told him that, you know, that why not let me help you? I've always been wanting to help you. Let me come in and help you. I will try my best to do whatever you can and follow your step. So he was actually very touched when I said to him very sincerely. And the next day I just quit my job. Hello, Ruong Shifu. Okay, today I have a case. The wake is at 3 p.m. Funeral day is Saturday, 3 p.m. as well. Okay, this old lady, she's by the name of Lim Eng, Madam Lim Eng. She's 100 years old already, and she has no family members now, okay? So we'll treat her as our own family members and conduct Buddhist funeral rites for her, okay? Sometimes we will get cases from the homes whereby the deceased have no next of kin. We'll actually head down to visit the homes to understand more about the deceased's background, to get more leads so that we can locate their family members. Besides that, we also open up to the media so that they can actually help us spread the news, and it's faster in that way to reunite these families. And there are many a times that we manage to reunite families in such cases.
She has followed me about 6 to 8 months. I've seen her visiting hospital, talking to clients and visit the family. I believe Jenny has the heart to follow my footsteps and I'm sure that she's capable to carry on what I have done.
Today, I tell you what, today we have to collect another 2 bodies from block 24, Beyond Crescent.
The most important thing also I tell her, you must help those destitute where they are poor and they cannot afford it and try to send them off in a proper way. You remember about this lady who is Liu Hongmei?
My dad is often in the press, not because he wants publicity. In fact, we actually do free funerals for the children and the old age, destitutes who are not reported on the news. So through the media, many Singaporeans will step forward to lend a helping hand to these families. And people do step forward to identify their family members and we'll be very happy because the deceased managed to get a final send-off from their loved ones. On the first day of my job, I wanted to go into the embalming room. So I walked straight into the embalming room. Before I reached the door, all my male colleagues were shouting at me, no, don't go in. But I told them I'm okay, don't worry. I'm mentally prepared. So I just walked in and I stood there, looked at the deceased body for a couple of minutes. I feel respect. I don't feel any fear. I've never once looked back into joining back to the corporate world, because the fulfillment that I get from this job, it far outweighs the kind of adjustment that I need to make in my life. It's very meaningful and rewarding. We want to debunk the myths of this profession, and we want more people to join us in this trade. Because we are facing an aging population, if no one wants to do this, then there'll be nobody who's doing it. I intend to do this for the rest of my life, and I've never looked back since.